The thing is, it's actually a very spicy food. But not that you like it like that, but you just ate it.
What the fuck? Oh,
hi guys, welcome back to Wako's Review, the only Nigerian YouTuber that is secretly an assassin. So if you are new here, please kindly subscribe and turn on that post notification so you'll be notified whenever I post by clicking on that bell. Do you understand? You know what the bell looks like, so click on it. All right, rolling through. I never thought that I would be this invested in a show, and I hate how it's treating my emotions. It's treating me like a guy that only wants to sleep with a girl, but the girl is just reluctantly in love with art, and that artwork is so good that it becomes a sad art. The art is a type of art that shocks other artists because of how artistic it is. Yeah, I don't even know where I was going to with that one. AZ episode 9 titled Faceless, like that one episode of Avatar that he met the Faceless. No one cares. No one cares about Avatar. Alright, moving on. But in episode 9, Cassie started off being pissed, or better still, angry at Princess because of how their friend was killed. And it was just both of them feeling unwanted and feeling like animals because they killed one of their friends. Then this one went on a tangent on how she would be happier if she was poor. And I would just say this, be poor. I hear me? Be poor. Let's see how long that your happiness will last. Princess also tried to explain, but to be honest, Princess, there's no way you can explain this. You killed somebody. Take it or leave it. You killed somebody. Don't even try and explain anything. Then after Cassie calmed down, Princess then showed her who was boss.
Cassie.
What?
What you just did this night, for the sake of Tony, I'll let it slide. Oh!
On the other end of the show, someone I don't talk so much about is George. He's still doing what he knows best, talks in a very bassish voice, and scares me with the way he looks into your soul like he's three steps ahead of you, no matter what. But first, we knew he wouldn't allow Otumba win just like that, so he called Otumba's son to meet him in this fancy restaurant. And before Otumba's son could say anything, George was like, "Do you like my native? The finest tailor in Lagos did it." He did not have like this girly tone, but I don't know. It sounded just like that to me. Then he goes ahead to badmouth Otumba, like he really destroyed this man's whole career. Yeah. Saying he's an evil demon, also adding that he's a cold-hearted beast that sells drugs. And the son was like, "Yo, man, that's my papa." I like how after he said all those things, he then said this.
"I didn't want to bring this up. I'm a man who believes in letting sleeping dogs lie."
Stop the cap.
But George's main purpose for this meeting was to persuade Otumba's son by promising him a seat in the House of Representatives. Did it work? We will see. With all that was happening, Aziz was one character that could care less, because all that was on his mind was his babe that he almost had an accident with. You know what they say? The person that survives an accident with you is probably your wife to be in the future. Wako 2001. That's how 2001 should be written. He complimented her just after she asked him to compliment her. He said what she's wearing is his favorite color. She said blue. He said no, pink. I'm talking about your bro. He then saw Cassie in the restaurant, then did his best to avoid eye contact. And except from that, everything seemed to be going on fine. And I was shocked. Like, normally, when Aziz is having fun, something bad always happens. But this scene was actually very... of course. He gets a call. After getting the call, he left his babe. He then took Princess to the same person that almost got him killed. Aziz now said what everyone was thinking.
"Are you a dog?"
Hey man, see. We said we were thinking about it. No one told you to say it. No one told you. Episode 10 continued from where it stopped after the wonderful slap. But this time, Aziz and Princess somewhat reconcile, and I think it's because of the money. I mean, the guy is earning 100,000 naira. If I was earning that amount, I'm going to definitely apologize. Slap me more, baby. What am I doing for you? Just driving? What? Just driving? But this episode then takes a massive U-turn, and it's not a funny U-turn, guys. So Aziz checks the bonnet thingy. See, I don't even know what that thing is. Yes, and if you know what it is, drop it down in the comment section. Please help me. But what he saw shook him, shook me, shook everybody that watched it. So what happened was, apparently Princess is HIV positive, but that's not the only problem. Cassie is also HIV positive. What I tell you guys, it's a dark show. They must make everything just dark. My happiness level reduced after I saw that thing. I was not even happy anymore, like them, man. AZ then went home, and guess what happened next?
Nonsense.
Listen, you were right. I have always been on your side, Dari. I've always said Aziz should focus on school, but the guy just wants to be doing anyhow. Now, see him. But after the little fight that ended with AZ ignoring her by turning his body the other way, we then see a newspaper. And I don't know who buys a newspaper in 2020. I've not seen a newspaper in a very long time. I just saw a newspaper now in a very long time. I did not know it was in this house. Then on the newspaper, you can see that Otumba's sex tape was leaked. But again, the question goes, who exactly did this? Okay, this side is not complicated, but a lot happened in a short period of time, so I'm going to increase my pace somehow in telling you. Cassie called AZ, then when AZ went to see her, she dropped a Ghana Must Go bag in his car. Then it turns out that what was in that bag was a whooping 20 million naira, which was apparently given to her by Otumba's son to run away from Nigeria and start a new life. But she wants to actually start the new life with, guess who?
Easy.
Why does he name like that? But he denied her faster than a cheating husband that his wife read the cheating husband. Yeah, the joke was funny. Yeah. After denying her, she then gave him 3 stacks and told him to leave the state. At the end of the show, he was hit by the police because they feel he is a thief, which is only telling me they probably set him up. The only issue I think I have with this show is just how secretive the characters are. Everyone is just hiding something, and I'm in a loop. I don't know what's happening, but the good thing about it is we are going to finally know what is transpiring in the last 2 episodes that are going to be coming out. So I'm very excited for that. My expectations are simple. Dari is the main character. I've always supported her from the beginning.
Stop the cap.
AZ is the second main card. AZ is going to die in the next episode. Tell me your expectations down below, and trust me, it's scary to watch this show now, but I feel that is the fun of it because it is scary. Okay, and I'll leave you guys with this last note. I still want to know what this guy is looking at. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you're enjoying the show also, because I'm really enjoying it. I like the fact that it is dark, and it is dark. Like the last episode, episode 10, it was so intriguing that I was just like consuming it. I was eating it because like it was just like, oh, this happened, that happened. You can't even take a drink. Another bad thing has happened. And it's good. Yeah, you understand? It's good. So yeah, question of the day. What was the first video of mine that you watched? Drop it down in the comment section. Yeah. And yeah, that's all. We got 30,000 subscribers. Thank you very much. I'm making a massive video. Not a massive video. But I'm making a video, Sha, later on. So thank you guys for watching. And we'll catch ourselves on the next one. Dab, please. We need to change. And so many we don't need to break. Don't come by sex on your prayer. No.